When talking about various viruses and diseases, you may have heard of the term disease vector or disease vector species before. And this sounds a little bit complicated, but actually it's quite simple. So in today's bit of content, we're going to share with you what a disease vector is and some examples of disease vectors. Now, for you mathematical folks out there, we're not talking about mathematical vectors or anything like that. We are talking about vectors as it relates to diseases and viruses. So, what is a disease vector? Well, a disease vector is typically a creature, but it can be any method in which a particular agent carries and transmits an infectious pathogen into another living organism. So, simply put, it's a method for diseases and viruses to enter other living organisms. Let me give you a good example here to help cement this in. Mosquitoes are technically considered some of the most deadly creatures in the world. The reason for this is because they help transmit malaria, and malaria kills almost 1 million humans every single year. However, malaria cannot transmit typically from person to person. You could have physical contact with someone that has malaria, and there's like a 99% chance you're going to be okay. You're not going to catch malaria. So how does malaria spread? Well, when a mosquito bites that infected person with malaria, the mosquito is going to get malaria, and then the mosquito can then transmit that to another human being. Or in some cases, the mosquitoes will actually have some type of coexisting relationship with a virus or deadly pathogen. That is, the deadly pathogen won't kill the mosquito, it'll just live in a symbiotic relationship. This means that it's kind of just dormant in the mosquito until the mosquito can inject the virus or pathogen into another human. So in this example of malaria, the mosquito or insect which helps malaria transmit from human to human is the disease vector. Mosquitoes are a disease vector species because while the mosquito themselves aren't that deadly, they can transmit deadly viruses and pathogens which would otherwise not be able to transmit. Another example of a disease vector species would actually be the raccoon. Raccoons can often get rabies, and sometimes it kills them and makes them crazy, but other times rabies will be slightly dormant inside of the raccoon, during which time, if a raccoon bites you, that rabies can enter your bloodstream and end up infecting you. So in this case, it's called a rabies vector species. It is the raccoon is the vector for the rabies to spread to other creatures. Now, there's all kinds of disease vector species. For example, like we said, there's mosquitoes, there's raccoons, and bats would be another example. But all that you need to know is any creature which can take a disease or virus and spread it to another person or organism in order to transmit that virus or pathogen is going to be a vector species. One more example of this would actually be parasites and microbes, which are excellent at transmitting infectious pathogens between creatures. So we hope you enjoyed this little bit of content here and now understand what a disease vector species is. And if you have any other ideas of what disease vector species we could list, make sure to leave it in the comments section below. By the way, raccoons, skunks, bats, birds, all kinds of creatures can be disease vector species. And we at WildlifeX team specialize in safe and responsible removal of these creatures and restoring them into the wild in the event that they infest your home, your apartment building, your workplace, any of that stuff. So if you think you have a wildlife or pest related problem, make sure to give us a call at 855-WILDLIFE or visit wildlifexteam.com and we will be sure to take care of the animals or pests ethically and if possible, restore them to the wild so that way there's no chance of these disease vector species transmitting anything to you. Thank you so much and we'll see you later.
Having trouble with wildlife in your home or office? Wildlife X Team is your solution to get rid of the raccoons, bats, rats, and snakes. Having a professional team, we offer both residential and commercial animal removal methods by using innovative and integrated techniques. Our services include animal trapping, dead animal removal, nuisance wild animal control, and animal capture. What are you waiting for? To get 24/7 service, call us at 855-WILDLIFE for an affordable solution for your nuisance wildlife issues.